Often as traders and investors, we wonder what the market has in store for us in coming months. And it's certainly not a question that can be answered with certainty. In this video, however, I want to dive into an interesting aspect of stock markets, explaining how the performance in the first half of the year might relate to the second half. Specifically, can observing the first 6 months' performance provide any useful insights for the rest of the year? Well, we certainly won't know until we test this hypothesis. As always, using a quantitative approach. So let's skip the chatter and go straight to the chart. First, let's take a look at what's plotted on the chart. Here, I've charted the Dow Jones Industrial Average, one of the most significant and historically rich indices. In this case, you can see I've plotted data from 1920 up to the present day. What's the advantage of having such a long historical record? When taking a longer-term approach with fewer trades, a larger sample size helps us gather more relevant data. Now let's take a closer look at the strategy. Here you can see I've drawn a simple blue rectangle that indicates the performance for the first 6 months of the year, selected without any particular criterion. As you can see, the rectangle starts on the first available trading day in January and ends on the last trading day in June. In this example, you'll notice that the performance for the first 6 months was positive. The goal is now to evaluate whether there's any relationship between this performance in the first half and the remaining months of the year. Now let's dive into the code. As you can see here, it's just 11 lines with comments and spaces, so nothing overly complex. Let's start with the first part. In this part, I calculated the performance of the first 6 months, essentially what's shown in this blue box. How did I pinpoint the opening value for these first 6 months? With a simple condition. If the current year's bar differs from the previous year, then it's the first day of a new year. So on that first day, we assign that value to this variable. Next, how did I identify the closing value on the last day of June? It's similar in logic. If the current month differs from the previous month and it's July, we assign the previous bar's closing value to this variable. Understanding the code or the conditions isn't essential here. What's important is that the variable value 2 represents this closing value, while value 1 represents the opening value. Now let's look at the market entry point. The entry occurs if value 2 is greater than value 1 and it's July. In other words, there needs to be a positive performance and it must be July. As for the exit, well, it's straightforward. When we moved into the next year, we sell on the next bar with a market order. We do this because our aim is to assess what happens in the following 6 months after a positive first half. Now let's look at the strategy's performance, which I've already added to the chart. But before seeing that, there's an interesting aspect to highlight regarding the trade size. In this case, instead of using a single contract per trade, I assigned a specific capital value to each entry. Here, I chose $1 million, and that's for a very simple reason. It's because the Dow Jones index is worth around 40,000 points today, making $1 million position size more efficient for our backtest. All right, let's go and see the strategy's performance. In this case, since the first 6 months' performance was positive, we bought at the first available July bar and closed at year end. Moving to the performance, as you can see, we have a fairly steady equity line. There are noticeable drawdowns, such as during the 1929 to 1930 crash or the 1987 crisis. When such events occur, since the simple strategy doesn't have a stop loss or other exit techniques, we remain exposed in the market for 6 months each year. Yet overall, the equity line is strong. Now let's examine the average trade. Here you'll notice that the average trade is around $55,000. It's a substantial figure, but keep in mind we're entering with $1 million. This gives us an average trade profit of about 5.5%, which is definitely not bad, especially since we're only in the market for 6 months. But let's answer our initial question and check if the first 6 months' performance really affects the rest of the year. To do this, let's reverse the entry condition. Instead of looking for a positive performance, let's see what happens if the first 6 months are negative. After compiling the script, you'll notice that here there's no entry anymore. This is correct, since the first 6 months were positive. Let's have a look at the equity line and you'll see It's less consistent than the previous one. The average trade here is about $28,000, around 2.8%. So that's about half of what we saw with a positive start. All right, so now let's try to explain what we observed. The most logical explanation ties back to investor psychology. When the first half of the year shows a positive performance, there might be a greater willingness to invest, boosting the second half's performance. On the other hand, if the first half is negative, investors might be more cautious, leading to a weaker second half. This could be a plausible explanation, though there are certainly others. The key takeaway is to maximize insights gained from market data, which in this case we did using a quantitative approach.